How is everyone? So lovely to be here. I just want to take a minute before we start any of this, just to say thank you, you know, from the bottom of our heart. Like, we've been trying to do something like this for you all for such a long time. And it's never really found its place, but yeah, when we started playing the songs like this, there was only one group of people that we wanted to share them with before the rest of the world. So we're really, really, really pleased that we could do this, and we're super happy that you all come out. So thank you very much, and thank you for being here. It's a set list and a half, like it's a pretty brutal. So a lot of these songs we haven't played for such a long time, and we hear you. You know, we hear you asking for them at every gig, and sometimes we're just not ready for those moments. Not ready to break my heart again. But we've been rehearsing them, and they're sounding really, really great. So thank you for the past sort of 8 years and all the constant support. It's honestly, we wouldn't be the same band without you. So this is our thank you to you. It's a bit sad one, but yeah, hold on to your seats, I guess. This song is called Anxiety. Telling me I can't believe I can. lyrics here because these are like, some of these are long ago. And after we finished touring them the first time around, I was like, okay, that's staying there. And here we are. Yesterday I had the lyrics out and I still fucked them up and I thought, that's as bad, first song as well. We're going to play this one and then we're going to answer some questions. We're going to open up the floor and you can ask away. There were some horrible ones yesterday, so go easy, be gentle. Okay. This one I wrote when I just first had my daughter was on the way, and I just was so scared of life, right? And throughout, like she's 8, she's gonna be 9 next month, and I'm still terrified. So this one's for all the parents in the room. Godspeed.
Trust and go.
Thank you. This one to me, old man. He was like, just have all the screens, see them all. And I was, and we put it out. And we,
did we go on as well and play like for like half an hour just on the stage, so it didn't feel so weird?
Yeah.
Because we were backstage and we realized we were about to walk out into just a cold, empty venue. Normally we come out and it's warm and it's energy. So we were like, we're just gonna have to go and just play. So before it turned on, we're just on there, just freshening ourselves.
I'm trying to get sweaty. Yeah. Yeah. And then the most surreal moment of it all is like, we go on and we see the same people that would be in the front rows of the World Gigs, right? But in their living rooms. And then you're like, oh, okay, this is wild. And then the next thing you see is like people moshing in their living rooms. So I would ask you the same question. How surreal was it for you to be kicking off? Because we saw a lot of crazy shit up there. Wow.
A couple of weird things happened.
There was some great moments. I mean, we panned to a few people, and the one couple had definitely they were just. They were like putting their clothes back on. I remember hearing in my ears, another screen. Wild. Who's next? Anyone else got?
Carter. A couple of weeks ago, I saw Yuki Sub's final tour.
Yeah.
Charlie Harper's 79. How do you envision yourselves fronting a rock band in 40 years' time? And on that subject.
Fuck, he knows my age. Savage bastard. Just keep that quiet.
That was so under. That was so under.
Say again?
That's a good video. Anyway, also on that subject, which, if any, old school bands from before your time influence you?
Yeah, so I love Sham 69. They got a song called Borsal Breakout, which I just love. I've always loved that band. I actually went and saw, of all bands, Sick of It All played a gig in the, what's the little one around the back of Top Hall Road? Of the Meat. It's all gone now. But
when?
LA2?
Not the LA2. There was a one right around the
border. Oh, yeah. First London show.
Yeah, it was, yeah. And I went and saw them play, went and saw Sick of It All play, and they played Borsal Breakout, and all they saw was me just fucking coming straight out. I was like, out of my fucking way. I grabbed the mic off him and sang it, and he was just cracking up. Like, so yeah, Sham 69, we all love, like, we love all sorts of music, and obviously, like, old school punk rock is, like, such an important foundation of my life, just the attitude and the sound, but yeah, Sam is my band. I love Crass, I love all that stuff, so yeah. And at 79, I will 100% be playing shows. Absolutely. Yeah. They might be wheeling me on. You're gonna have to stand up and you're gonna have to project. This is your moment.
Fucking love your new song.
Thank you.
Thank you. I'm a bit shy at recognizing genres, but how would you class your new song? Like, how would you describe it, please?
What genre is the new song? My con. That sounds like a Dean question. Exactly,
he's
a producer.
Just rock. Yeah, none of this sort of like 15 names for one thing. It could just be under the large umbrella of rock music that we love.
But that's interesting, of course. When you're
no,
when
you
you're
said
making
I'm answering this.
I'm gonna tell them the story about the sampler.
Yeah, no, that I love, yeah, go on.
While we were making our record, we'd go through lots of changes of the songs, obviously, and we'd throw them in a playlist every now and again. And SoundCloud does this beautiful thing where it tells you what you're making, it tells you what genres it falls into, and fuck me, it went through. It went, at one point it was ska punk, and I was like, there's no fucking money. But right, ska, but yeah, dream pop, yeah. Dark wave.
But eventually it did settle when we put the final album in with the masters, it just said rock, one genre. Right. I sent a screenshot to you and was like,
so we're you know, a lot of people call us a punk band for forever and ever. Yesterday, we were a hardcore punk band. That's all we got. And for us, we've always been a rock band. Like, I grew up on rock music, and I grew up on all forms of it. I don't like breaking it down into little bits and pieces, but we're a rock band, and we always have been. And I think Man of the Hour is like probably the best rock song we've ever written. I think so. Yeah. Does that answer your question?
Yeah, thank you.
So we play some, we'll go and play a few more and then we'll answer some of the questions.
Thanks.
Right, this song. You're allowed to be cute. It's okay. It's a new song, it's off the new record, and this one goes back a while. We wrote this actually before we wrote Any and Sticky, and it just wasn't right for that record, you know, like, and we do that often. We write a bunch of songs and one will always not, like, not be ready. It just doesn't feel at home, and I'm not about, like, forcing things where they don't fit. So this one was from that, and I love it. Yeah, it's about a special moment between us and all the things that are happening in the world at the time. And yeah, so this one's called Sun Bright Golden Happening.
Please don't say no.
really important to them. This one's for you, and I guess time is a healer. I never really know how it's gonna go when we play these songs, but yesterday it fucked me up. So it sometimes it feels like that pain is never ever gonna end, you know. And I don't know. Sometimes I feel like it just shouldn't, you know. And that's okay as well. This song's for you, and it's for all those people up there in the castles and looking down on us. It's called Beautiful Death. Recently, that so much of that was just compounded by grief and grieving for years and years and years, and not realizing, not giving myself the space for that. Like, you know, as men, we're sort of told, now it's a bit better, but we grew up in a society that didn't want to hold the space for us like that, you know? It made you feel a lot of guilt and a lot of shame if you did that. So, I'm here to tell you that's fucking bullshit. And, And grief is a really powerful, important feeling, important emotion. And you have to give it the space it deserves. But it's very important to do that and prioritize that, because then you get some acceptance, and with acceptance comes forgiveness, and with that comes like an opportunity for a second life. So, and that's what I have now. I feel like I can play this song because of where I'm at now. Like I've never felt luckier than I am now. I genuinely feel so blessed to have these people as my, not just my friends, but my bandmates. Like, they blow my mind all the time. The crew that we've got, the team that we've got, make my days just effortlessly better. So this is, but fuck me, this is a, it's a fucker of a song, so. Apologies. You're all fucking crying already. All I can hear is sniffling. Now we're about to do this to her. Different set list. This song's called Bleed.
Sure, you'll be sweet.
Thank you very much, everybody.